Welcome back. In the last video, we have studied properties of nanoparticle. We have studied the components or the factors why there is change in properties of nanoparticles. So three factors we have studied: surface to volume ratio, quantum size effect, that is decrease in degrees of freedom, and then change in energy band structure. And the two properties, that is electrical properties and optical properties, we have studied for nanoparticle. Now we will discuss the further properties of nanoparticle one by one. Okay, so the next property we are going to study is the thermodynamic property. Okay, as we decrease the size of the particle, or at nano size, there is change in enthalpy and entropy of the nanoparticle. This is the major effect. There is change in enthalpy and entropy, and there is decrease in melting point. Now, why there is decrease in melting point? This we have studied. There is increase in surface to volume ratio in nano size. Okay. Now, what is the melting point? It is the temperature at which solid and liquid phases of the material are in equilibrium, or we can say here, and in the melting process, solid is converted into liquid. Now we know solid is the bound state, though atoms are closely bound to each other, and in liquid phase we know, as compared to solid, the atoms or molecules are in free state. Now, due to increase in surface to volume ratio, more number of atoms are on the surface. So, energy required to free these atoms is less, and therefore there is decrease in melting point at nano size for nanoparticle. Okay. Now, next is the adsorption site. Now, there is increase in surface to volume ratio. So, this is the bulk material, and we can see these are the surface area. So, these are the foreign atoms or molecules, they are adsorbed on the surface. Okay. Now, if this bulk material is converted into nanoparticle, so we see there is increase in surface area. So, there is increase in adsorption site. So, more number of atoms or molecules, they get adsorbed here. Okay, so this is the nanoparticle of 100 nanometer or less than 100. So there is increase in surface area or increase in adsorption site. Okay, so this can also be used for adsorption of hydrogen atoms. Okay, now next property we are going to study is the mechanical property. Okay, there is increase in yield strength and hardness of the particle as it becomes nanoparticle. So, we can say that the nanoparticles are very strong. And one more peculiarity, it shows high strength and ductility. We know high strength and ductility, they do not or they rarely coexist. But at nano size, we get these two properties together. Okay. Next property we are going to study is the chemical properties. Okay. This is about chemical reactions. Now we know when two different atoms or two different molecules, when they come in actual contact, when the two atoms or two different molecules, they actually come in contact, then chemical reaction occurs. So these two atoms or two molecules, they have to come in physical contact, then only chemical reaction will occur. If they are separated by some distance, then chemical reaction between the two will not happen, because in chemical reaction, the two atoms, two molecules, they come in contact and the separate bonding occurs to give new chemical compound. Okay. For nanoparticle, there is increase in surface area. So we can say that two atoms or two molecules, they actually come in contact. So we can say that chemical reaction occurs at the surface. Now for nanoparticles, there is increase in surface area, and therefore chemical reactivity also increases in case of nanoparticle. Okay, due to larger surface area, these nanoparticles are more reactive than their bulk form. Okay. Now, next property is the magnetic property of the nanoparticle. Okay, so when we consider the nanoparticle, we know its dimensions are less than 100 nanometer. So in nanoparticle, in one nanoparticle, whatever atoms present or atomic dipoles present, they are aligned in only one direction as shown here. Okay, so this is, we consider one nanoparticle. So in this nanoparticle, all atoms or all atomic dipoles are aligned in only one direction. So we can say that one particle is one domain, or it is a single domain, and therefore it has net magnetization. Okay, so this is the nanoparticle. It is a single nanoparticle and it is single domain, because all the atomic dipoles in this nanoparticle are aligned in only one direction. So it is a single domain and has net magnetization. But this direction of magnetization continuously changes. We can see here. So this is the nanoparticle at this instant. The next instant, its direction, it becomes like this. Okay, next, its direction becomes like this. If you look at it at the next moment, you will see this direction. Okay, you will see this direction, and next moment, this direction. So what does it mean? It continuously flips the direction. So if we try to measure the magnetization, then average will become zero. Because to measure the magnetization, we require some time. Okay, but within that time, there is change in direction of this domain. Okay, we can see here. So at first instant, this is the direction. Next moment, this is the direction. This is the next moment. This is the next moment. So next moment, again, it will be vertically downward. Again, this direction. So when we try to measure the magnetization, the average magnetization becomes zero. And this phenomenon is called as superparamagnetism. Okay. So when external magnetic field is applied, then magnetic moment tends to align in the direction of the field. Okay, when we apply the external magnetic field, suppose this is the external magnetic field, then this direction will prevail and then we get net magnetization. Okay, so this is about the magnetic properties of the nanoparticle. Okay, once again I repeat, this is superparamagnetization, superparamagnetism. Due to flip in the direction, and this flip is randomly it changes the direction. So average magnetization or average value of magnetization is zero. So that is superparamagnetism. And when we apply the external magnetic field, then all the atomic dipoles, they get aligned in the direction of field, and therefore we get the net value of magnetization. So this is about the different properties of nanoparticles. So we have seen electrical, optical properties, thermodynamic properties, chemical properties, and then magnetic properties of nanoparticle. So these are different properties of nanoparticles. So we stop here. In the next video, we will discuss different applications of nanoparticle. Okay. Thank you.